voices. Where am I? I know this place. I've been here before. I've been here my entire life. I'm trapped in here. These stairs. I'm climbing these stairs again. I need to get out. The voices are calling me. Music box. It's broken. I have to fix my old music box. I have to get it. I have to... Those horrible dreams again. I've had them repeatedly ever since my mother died and left me that music box in her will. Harry always said that old family heirloom had something to do with my family's strange disease. If the doctors won't give us an answer about your illness, I'll search for one myself, you said. And in that search, it seems you lost yourself. I don't think I'd ever...
Pardon me, madam, but the island is in sight. We'll be lowering the boat in just a minute.
Oh, thank you so much, Captain Hodgson. I'll be right out. All right. Time to gather my things. What was I thinking when I brought all these I received a mysterious package at my house. I stored... Oh, I'd better cover up my hands before I leave the cabin. I wouldn't want anyone thinking I'm a circus freak. Oh my, I have the worst memory. I forgot the combination again. Thank goodness I always bring my journal with me to write things down. I love this song. Ah, the amazing adventures of Nora Everhart. After spending so much time reading this book, I think I've learned... All right, now it's open. I saw this island in one of my unsettling dreams. I drew it. This strange and... sharp relic came in the package I received at Harry Everhart, my husband, my partner, and my dear old.
We're all set, madam.
Okay, Nora. From here on out, you're on your own.
Lower the motorboat. Be careful with Mrs. Everhart's equipment, lads. We'll be back to pick you up in 3 days. I really hope you find your husband there, madam.
I hope it too. I'll see you in 3 days then.
But please be careful on that island. You know what the legends say about it.
I'll take care. Thank you, Captain Hodgson. Well, here I am, in the middle of the ocean after traveling across half the world. Just miles away from where my husband is supposed to be. You left a year ago to search for a cure for my affliction. Your letters kept me close to you, but suddenly they stopped coming. What happened, Opal? What did you find? Whatever it was, it led you to hire a crew and set sail from San Francisco to Tahiti. And from there, to this place. An island in the middle of the Pacific that the locals refused to even name. Everything is familiar. So familiar. As impossible as that may sound. Is this the island I dreamed about? This can't be a coincidence. Idyllic island, surrounded by deadly reefs and protected with stakes to keep anybody from entering. Why? There's definitely something strange about this place. Okay, Harry. Let's see if I can find any trace of you around
here. I know it's just resonance, but
I do love listening to the sea in them. A tent. So somebody was on this island recently.
A miniature va'a.
A Polynesian outrigger canoe. Beautifully crafted, too. A note written in French. I only understand two words, île and mort, island and death. It must be a warning. This machete is completely worn down. The blade is dull. I feel quite good. I dare say I might even walk a little faster than usual. Those markings seem to represent the sea. I'll make a note of them in my journal. It might come in handy. Looks like it opens from the other side. These wooden figures are called Unu. This seems to be telling a story. Bone fish hook.
It may look peaceful, but clearly somebody wants to... What a lovely flower offering. What a lovely flower offering. Carving tool. This box. CW. Those are the initials on the brass key. It opens it. So whoever sent me this key was here. This is starting to look like a scavenger hunt. From what I've read, the Polynesians don't need doors. So why build so? Oh, that did something. Something's missing here. Well, look what's hidden here. This may be the first time I trespass a private property. My childhood in Newburyport wasn't exactly the most thrilling thing. Lady Shannon? That name sounds familiar. I'd better check my journal. Is that... Harry?
Harry! You were here!
You were here and I found you, dammit! Where are you now? Where is everybody? Where did you and all your crew go? This reminds me of those slot machines that Harry and I saw at the Atlantic City Pier. The Polynesian version. It's been years since I took such a long walk. This fresh air is doing me wonders. I can feel the air is denser here in this mangrove swamp. Rays of sunlight shining through. Another symbol. Now that I've crossed half the world, I wouldn't mind crossing the other half. But I have to do it with you, old pal. This sort of pond is a Polynesian fishing technique. There's another symbol inside it. A bone fish hook. my, this is so beautiful. What were these birds called? Lorikeets. Cole's lorikeets. There are lorikeet feathers scattered around this Unu. I'll draw the symbol in my journal. A mechanical bridge? That doesn't fit in with Polynesian traditions either. Thank you. What a beautiful mountainous landscape.
Well, I guess I hit the jackpot. That's my ticket across the river then. Steady now.
How long have I been walking? I've lost track of the time. Wow, what is this place? I'd better have a look around this abandoned village. Harry's crew might have stayed here. This enormous stone slab looks like a mechanism to get... something missing here. Everhard Expedition. They set up camp here. Could these tikis be some sort of guardians? So now you believe in magic, old pal? A Polynesian man covered in tattoos. I'm not sure if he looks angry or scared. Well, what well? Fascinating. Looks like some of the crew members didn't get along too well. A forbidden ritual? This fella sounds pretty hot-headed. Blowing an ancient hatch with dynamite sounds like a fool's errand to me. I've never cared much for games of chance. Very neat. His real name was Costas? I'm not sure what to expect on this island, but I hope I won't regret not having a gun. Nice comb. An amulet with a carved Marquesian cross. Look at this little fellow. Why is this hammock so far from the rest of the campsite? The river cuts through that canyon. It doesn't look safe to cross. Damn it. Someone on the expedition died. He seems confused, as if he was having a hard time writing this down. Did they use all the dynamite? Farewell message from a friend. I never thought that this expedition would cause anybody's death. Oh, I'm sure Harry never thought so either. If he'd known this was going to happen, he'd never have come here. Close to a grave since my mother's burial. Shortly after she died, my lovely Dalmatian spots, as Harry used to call them, appeared. We thought it was nothing at first. This enormous... stone slab looks like a mechanism to get up to the outcrop. There's something missing here. A tiki, like something straight out of an adventure novel. They're composed of four pieces. What a delicate piece of craftsmanship. Broken, but I might as well draw what I can see of it in my journal. It's some sort of Polynesian coat of arms. Is that an octopus? Something's missing inside that emblem. They use the emblem as a headstone for Roy's grave. This one resembles a shark. Did they use all the dynamite? I must have found the luxury huts. Pretty swanky. Look at him. Giddy as a schoolboy.
Ikor?
Been ripped out of something else. I've seen Harry keep even restaurant checks for bookkeeping. He would never tear up a piece of valuable information. Got it. The parts of the tiki on this column seem movable. What kind of stone is this? I've never seen any substance quite like it. It feels Impressive work. Is that a fish? This appears to be the shrine of a Polynesian chieftain. Wow, really old photo. The island is wearing a lot of tribal ornaments, but none of them seem Polynesian. Black ooze again. Skin alterations. Like the ones on my hands. He's losing his mind. Cripes! This man was splashed with that black liquid.
Whoever took this picture must have a really cool head.
Those spots look all too familiar. Is this a picture of my hand? Erythrocytes. Aren't those red blood cells?
Ugh, I can't stand the smell of medical equipment. Reminds me of my illness.
I'd better not touch it. And given what happened, they shouldn't have either.
Is this stone structure a hatch of some sort?
Well then, I'm going down. Come on, Nora. Deep breath. I almost feel as if they're watching me. Is somebody whispering? Hello?
Were these eyes related to the ritual? Are these ornamental?
Oh, I feel disoriented down here.
This eye... Is it calling to me? Do they have two pupils?
I can press these star-shaped tiles.
Are these ornamental?
Or something else? I feel disoriented down here.
Were these eyes related to the ritual? Another eye.
I hear whispering. I almost feel as if they're watching me.
Do they have two pupils? Were these eyes related to the ritual?
I hear it. I'd better draw it just in case.
Oh, the whispering, it stopped. Was I imagining all that?
I think I solved it. I wonder what I might be able to see with this lens. I wonder what I might be able to... It fits. What? What on earth? What is happening? My God. What? What was that that I saw? What were those stars? I solved it.
Great Scott! The well is filling up. That's black ooze.
No.
It's happening. I'm faint.
What is this? Where am I? Am I dreaming again? This is different. It isn't my recurring dream. I can't stop walking. My legs aren't responding. Holy Moses, what is that creature on the horizon? Wait a moment, No! Underwater! I have to get back. I have to find... What is that? What kind of creature is this? I need to get a closer look. Oh, how did I get to this beach? Oh, I have a terrible headache. That ship, torn apart and cast so far up the beach. What on earth could have happened to it? I wonder what else could be seen beyond these shores. Ropes, ropes, ropes are frayed. There are strange marks on the wooden pole. Looks like they took items from the stranded ship. I believe Harry visited this exposition when he was looking for answers for my illness. My God! Look at his contorted face! Is this what's going to happen to me? Those footprints definitely do not look human. Those footprints definitely do not look human. This picture is taken from a distance. What is he doing? Floating rocks? What happened on this ship? He's repairing my old music box. Attack? What attack? Photographic film. It's too dark to see any.
A pulp magazine. I love Chandorov. Never heard of this Eric Zan fella. Someone here had a green thumb.
The expedition only has 5 members now. There are only 4 chairs around the campfire. Oh dear, this dock was a certifiable loon. The doctor was certainly well supplied with all these medical tools are hair-raising. A white fedora. It's really dirty. A handkerchief with the letters EDW. Discarded clothing. It hasn't been worn in a long time. I'm glad you stayed by his side, whoever you are.
These two fellas seem to get along pretty well.
It might need to be turned on. I've never seen Harry so angry. These symbols are linked to the piano keys. Wow, look at the size of these stones. A rock stained with black ooze. Looks like the prototype of some... How can someone build something like this out of stone? You always did have a good ear, Harry. It's curious, but it's the first time since I got sick that I feel useful. Harry is depending on me, and not the other way around. What odd structure. It doesn't look like a building, though. Sometimes I still doubt whether this isn't just some ghastly dream. The doctor was certainly well supplied with all kinds of... no power. Dead as a doornail. My god. The ship's hull was ripped open. A few jagged rocks couldn't have caused a gash of this size. This place gives me the creeps. I can't see any trace of the ship's crew, nor their remains. No power. This is right. Nope, wrong. I'll try again. voice. Is that Harry? No, just a recording. Even the crew of the ship that brought Harry's expedition to this island were afraid of it. This is the captain's last entry.
74 nautical miles east of Tahiti. The Lady Shannon has run aground. Its crew is unaccounted for.
The ship was whaling not far from here.
But we're stranded on this island. Please send help immediately.
These knobs must control the vibrations inside this chamber.
The Lady Shannon has run aground. Its crew is unaccounted for. Five of us have survived, but we're stranded on this island. Please send help immediately. This is a distress call from the Everhart expedition. 74 nautical miles east of Tahiti.
The Black Ooze's properties are perplexing.
Unaccounted for. Five of us have survived.
And I was completely covered in that black goo. I wonder what it'll do to me.
This is a distress call from the Everhart expedition. 74 nautical miles east of Tahiti.
Maybe the legend is more real than it seems.
Five of us have survived.
What were you looking for in the heart of the island?
Please send help immediately. This is a distress call from the Everhart expedition. 74 nautical miles east of Tahiti. The Lady Shannon has run aground. Its crew is unaccounted for. Five of us have survived, but we're stranded on this island. Send help immediately. This is a distress call from the Everhart expedition. 74 nautical miles east of Tahiti. The Lady Shannon has run aground. Its crew.
I'd better write down those numbers in my journal.
Five of us have survived.
Only God knows how long I've been covered in this black liquid. I wonder what it's going to do to me. Although I doubt anything could be worse than my illness. Workshop. You made it work, Harry. This must be the highest part of the island. And that diamond? What kind of machine? What kind of machine were you building? What kind of machine were you building? So this is the reason the ship was scavenged. Blowtorch. Looks like it's been... Back home. I'm going to read up on engineering. I've been interested in knowing how things work since I was a child, but I always thought technology wasn't for me. What nonsense. Huge stone door looks like an exit. How does it open? This ornate structure certainly isn't natural, but not man-made either. This feels ominous. Those symbols seem to indicate the height of the tide.
must be instructions to operate this bizarre structure. Those symbols seem to indicate the height of the tide. Those symbols seem to indicate the height of the tide.
quite scared of storms. When I was a child, I used to cover myself with the sheets to not listen to the noise of thunder. I honestly doubt I'd like to cover myself with anything in here. Time to overcome my fears, I guess. I hope you didn't borrow this slide projector from the University of Denver, old pal. I think this is the right one.
dear old pal. I think I'm getting closer to understanding what is happening to you. But it is taking a toll on my sanity. As fascinating as this island and its ancient and unfathomable wonders may seem, it's also a place plagued with misfortune and calamities. We lost Roy at the campsite. We almost lost our engineer on this beach. The doctor went mad and stabbed him with a strange knife. And all because of this island, Nora. Initially, we were optimistic and in high spirits, but now we've all become resentful and discouraged. Even I can feel how I am constantly assaulted by dark thoughts. Anyway, if what I am going through here helps me find you a cure, it'll have been worth it. I hope to find an answer in the temple on that mountain peak. Love you always, Harry.
Poor Harry. He is worried, exhausted, disheartened. I will find you, my love.
That was quite a hike. Mountain. I can see that giant diamond-shaped thing really close from here. Ah. Took me a while to get here, but the views are worth it. These drops of rain are so refreshing. Feels really good. Are these figures singing like a choir? So I guess you used the notes from the organ and they were... 1212, testing. Nope, doesn't work. Homemade loudspeakers. Probably to amplify the sound. There's a simple... inside. There are some sort of sound devices built around this amphitheater. Frank had a daughter named Evangeline. What a darling. They built a turbine to generate electricity under the falling water, but the stream isn't close enough to the wheel. Bible. It must have belonged to Frank. Blood-soaked rags. These levers connect those gears to direct the wheel's energy into the turbine. I'm really sorry about Frank. Harry, they built all this just with pieces from the beached ship. Frank sure must be a real whiz. Dead as a doornail. They built loudspeakers on top of this tower to reproduce the effect of the organ. Very clever, old pal. Nakal? So, this is like Atlantis, but in the Pacific Ocean, right? He thought it was a... His low spirits are obvious in this photo.
No power.
All right. Can you turn it on, Cass?
Please, sir. We should not do this.
Not now.
Haven't we had enough warning, Mr. Everhart? What else do we need? Another death?
Listen to me. Frank lost his life setting this whole thing up. So we're not going to discuss it anymore. We're going to activate it, period. That's clear enough for you.
Hey, hey.
I like singing so much. Harry and I often sang together. When heavens, looks like a rock slide crushed. The only tent that came out of the rock slide, torn picture. Maybe the Polynesian. The only tent that came out of the rock slide in one piece is the one filled with amulets. They didn't accept Frank in the university. They should be ashamed. These stone columns just vibrate. Amazing! The hatches are opening. Now the wheel is moving. was easy. These buttons seem to adjust the amount of energy that goes through the turbine. That should give the turbine some energy. We did it. Now everything should be powered. What? Did I do something wrong? Come on, work! Come on! Yes. Now what? What's happening this time? I can feel the fever rising. Oh God, no. My illness. Is it coming back? Is this an ocean? An ocean that dried up? My cane. These really are ancient bones of a very ancient creature. They are so dry. I need to find water. My bed. And how many times did I think I was going to die lying in this bed? Find some shade before I dry right up. The horseshoe-shaped pillar and that diamond shape again. I can't take much more of this. I feel woozy. That's not a house. That's our house in Inglewood. Am I dreaming? Or am I just losing my mind? That's our mailbox, too. Harry? Are you home? I miss you so much, old pal. I miss you so much, old pal.
picnic with Harry's brother and sisters. I started wearing gloves shortly after that. I am definitely losing my mind. I don't understand what is happening, Harry. Are you... Checkmate in three moves. Harry gave me this necklace after one of his scavenger hunts. It's a photo of my mother and me. She... The happiest day of my life. The Everhart twosome. My mother's music box. Yet again. What a sweet melody. What was that? Another vivid dream? And my music box again, but it wasn't broken anymore. And what a catchy tune. I've lived more in these last 2 days than in the previous 6 years. With my illness, I'd forgotten about the kind of person I am. I might not be daring, but I am determined. These drops of rain are so refreshing. Feels really good. Homemade loudspeakers. Probably to amplify the sound. I haven't sung since I got sick, but let's give it a shot. A show. This feels like hallowed ground. Are they bathing him? In black ooze. His hands are changing, like in my dream. Look at those spots. They look like mine. Now he's some sort of man-fish? Fish of every size and shape. This looks like the same kind of elevator that was in the campsite. These patterns look too familiar. She sounds worried for him, I think. Where is this taking me? Like I'm inside the giant fish head that I saw from below.
It's amazing how words and symbols can keep their meaning after thousands of years. A complex pattern. I've seen this symbol in the mural several times. I guess it can be applied to both water and blood. John McCormack's dear old pal of mine? A favorite song. Well done, Harry. Boy, am I lucky that you did the hard part of figuring things out. This one was really hard to figure out. Good job, Harry. I'm starting to understand this language. So that's how you mark the symbol's orientation. God's blood. Does this mean that... Is this related to me somehow, to my disease?
My dear old pal... Nora. I wish I could write something else. But a long time ago, I promised you I would never lie to you. So here goes. There is no cure for your illness. What you carry in your blood is changing you, and it will keep changing you until it's done, whatever that means. There is nothing we can do to stop it. My dear old pal, my partner, the love of my life, I am so sorry. I've made so many mistakes. All those deaths because of me. Frank, DeWitt, Roy, all for nothing. Maybe Teahoro is right. Maybe we can return to the beach and build a raft to get back to Papeete. Maybe in less than a month, I could be back.
There's no cure? But he didn't finish the letter. What did you do, Harry? Well, this one was easy, I think.
Oh!
Harry threw a bottle against the wall. Was it because he was frustrated for not deciphering this? Or because of what he discovered when he did? This is the right combination. A broken liquor bottle. Is this Harry's? He hates booze. It appears Harry didn't advance any further. Those are drums of some sort. What is that thing? Is that the outline of a hand? Let's try again. Nora, you idiot, just follow the sequence. I can sing, but I'm awful when it comes to playing music. For him, so it shouldn't work for me either. Unless there's something different about my hand. Anyway, Nora, you know what you've got to do. My hands! Look at my hands! This is definitely not a dream. And I'm starting to doubt the others were dreams, too. I should be scared, but it's hard to explain what I feel, but it isn't fear. Not a bit. Another one of those gates, like the one I saw in the temple. I'm back to being me. It's hard for me to understand how these gates work. What happens every time I cross one of them? Thank you. panel of this strange technology. What's it for? Something related to the currents? By underground currents. That architecture again. Where is this gate going to lead me now? Place.